It's the rate limiting step in the formation of carnosine. Mm-hmm. So you have beta-alanine, but you have histidine, and you form carnosine.
Right.
So carnosine is an intramuscular buffer of the pH changes. So if you go out and you do a horrible Metcon, you're trying to buffer some of that pH, or it's not lactic acid, so it's lactate plus pH that's created, and you're trying to buffer some of that pH. So beta-alanine helps with that within a single-digit percentage.
Right.
But it also has this other effect where it hits what's called the DRG in the spine, dorsal root ganglia, and that's what gives you that tingly feeling. It's completely unrelated to how the supplement is working. It just happens to have multiple effects. But people feel the kind of itchy tingling, and they're like, oh, my pre-workout's kicking in.
Yeah.
So a lot of times I put 3 grams in pre-workouts.
Now I know why.
The first time I remember crawling through your
yeah.
Veins.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, it's got to be working.
I've never had anyone give me an explanation for that.
Yeah.
Like missing the dorsal root ganglia piece, like it being the rate limiting step in the production of carnosine and intramuscular buffer and the whole deal.
Yep.
Like that's, I feel like that's really common, but no one ever mentions why you actually tingle.
Yeah, that's why. And what's interesting, if I remember correctly, it doesn't happen in Koreans. There's a genetic thing where Koreans don't have that effect. So what I've tried to do, and if anyone creates a supplement, you know, send me some money or whatever. But I think if you can create like a long-acting beta-alanine, I think that would be a pretty good seller. Because the rate-limiting step right now, it appears to be the total dose that you can take. So if we could give you, say, 100 grams of beta-alanine, you wouldn't feel like you're going to itch your face off or have any other issues. It appears that you may be able to saturate the muscle much faster. Because the hard part now, like beta-alanine, you need about 6 to maybe 9 grams, at least 6 grams per day.
Right.
But some people get itchies at, like, 1 gram.
I can get you, 1 or 2.
Right.
My brother, the first time he ever went to take beta-alanine, he went and bought it, and then he was, like, looking at it and couldn't figure out how much to take. There wasn't a scooper in there. And so if you've ever seen a beta-alanine scooper, it's like a 1 gram scooper.
Yeah, it's very small.
It's very small.
Really tiny. It's like 1 gram. And my brother, not knowing that it was going to be, because what other supplement has a 1 gram scooper? Like, nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah. Everything has like a 5 gram at like a minimum.
Yeah.
And so he just grabs this like a, you know, a teaspoon or a tablespoon spoon, like a kitchen spoon, like he fucking soup with, and just goes, oh, I think he said 2 of them. 1, 2. He probably had 20 grams, which, like, I have no interest in ever even attempting this to see what it would
feel like. It's like a form of torture.
That's like laying in insulation.
Yeah.
Like jumping into a pile of insulation and asbestos. Yeah. Like,
He said his whole body was on fire and
he didn't
know what the fuck was happening. Because I didn't even tell him that he was going to tingle. He didn't even know that was coming.
That was like a trick we would do on our friends when we'd first recommend beta-alanine. And it would be like, don't tell him about the tingles.
I love that there's like an entire company, like PSN, like just made an entire business
out of
just the itch.
Oh, yeah. Or if you've ever taken too much niacin, like the flush. The flush.
Oof.
I did that once. I was testing a supplement. I was an idiot. They sent it to me in the mail. I'm like, sure, I'll try this. And I'm like, oh, my God. I turn red.
Yeah.
And it feels horrible. And I look at the back, and I went, niacin. I don't remember the amount, but it was astronomically high. And I'm like,
I know a guy who was doing a bodybuilding show, and so he was taking niacin before went on stage.
Yeah.
And just like someone who's like never had a pot cookie before, and they eat it, and then like 60 minutes later, they're like, this thing isn't working.
Take more.
Eat another one. And then like 5 minutes later, it kicks in, and they're like, oh,
shit. As soon
shit.
As you
like,
swallow it.
So
you're like, that was a bad idea.
Oh. Same deal for him. He was like, fuck, I didn't take enough niacin. I got to be on stage in a second
or whatever.
And then took some more, and then like 10 minutes later, was just like overwhelmed, and then just kept getting worse and worse. And he was like the whole time just like trying to hold his shit together in front of like a big audience.
And those lights are bright. I mean, you're like, I mean, it's like,
like it's awful red. It's gonna pop.
You start turning purple. There's like those bodybuilders that you can see took too much and they literally have the purple tone to their skin. You're like, it's a lot of niacin.
It doesn't look so